right, this is going to be the Violent Femmes with Please Do Not Go. This is played on an acoustic bass, which is pretty cool. I'm pretty excited about this. If you have an acoustic bass, this would be fantastic. Really super addictive, fun riff for you to learn. But if you don't, that's totally fine. Obviously, I'm not playing it on an acoustic bass right now. I got my PV right up in here. And it's going to sound great either way, but I really love this riff because it's really fun to play. It's really bouncy. It's kind of happy, and I think you're going to like it a lot. Anyway, I am Finbar of Finbar Bass. Okay, so what are those bass videos all about down when you click on the YouTube text box right there? Well, bass playing is kind of a time of discovery, you know? It's like an adventure. You're learning new stuff all the time. You're increasing your chops. You're getting better, right? So we need to practice bass. And when we're practicing, you know, and learning all these different techniques, like through these videos, why not make it fun, right? I mean, that's great. If you can actually get better on the bass, you know, and learn all these different songs or techniques or whatever, and, you know, and have fun doing it instead of just doing it through, you know, repetitious, you know, study, then that's a fantastic thing, and that's fun. You're doing it through something that you love. You're doing it through music. And that makes it just so much easier to do and so much better. So don't forget, click on the clicker box right down there in the YouTube text box. I think it's really going to help you out. So if you're learning this riff and you've been at it for a while, it's like 20 minutes into it, and some of the parts just aren't coming out on your fingers like they're supposed to when you're thinking about it in your brain, and you know, maybe you're getting a little bit frustrated, seriously, don't worry about it. The whole idea behind all these is you have to build up a little bit of muscle memory for it, right? You're not going to be able to play it. No one can play it immediately, right away, right after they hear it, right? So don't be so hard on yourself. If you've been at it for a while, you know, you're working at this for like, you know, 20 minutes straight, just stop right there. I say this all the time. Go and play a video game, get something to eat, take your mind completely off of it, right? Because your mind is trying to wire this way for a long time. It's just not working out after a while. Go do something else, come back, and you will be better than when you stopped. For some magical reason, I don't know why that is, it's how our brains work. When you come back, it's going to be a lot easier for you to get back into it. And, you know, practice it a little bit each day, and you'll get it. No problem. You'll see. And it'll be fun. You'll be wanting to play it all the time and addictive. And I'm going to show you this right now. Let's roll right into it. All right. So you are going to start on the third fret of the E string. And you're going to hit it twice. And then you're going to slide from the first fret to the second fret of the A string. Just like that. Then you're going to hit that open D string. So far. Right? Then you're going to hit this fifth fret of the D string twice. So far. And what that was there is you got twice on the fifth fret of the D. You're going to move it down to the third fret of the D, right? Second fret, and then the fifth fret of the A string. So far. Just like that. A little faster. And then you got this. And, you know, you could switch this up while you're playing this song. This part right here, you got kind of a rest between third fret, second fret, third fret of the A. But you could play more staccato or blend it more together, you know, make it a little bit more interesting. But basically, you know, typically, you got a rest right there, so it's... And part of what makes this bass line sound so bouncy and fun are those rests that you put in there. So you're not just always playing it straight. It's more. So you get a little staccato in there and it sounds bouncier. And after the 3-2-3 on the A, you got the open A again and then the fifth fret. Just like that. Then you're going to go to this third fret of the D, second fret of the D, right? And this part is just played pretty quick. It's not too staccato. You're just playing it pretty fast. So you got third fret of the D, second fret of the D. Then you're going to hit the third fret of the A string. Go to the fifth fret of the A. Open A. And then second fret of the A. That's pretty much it. And you want to do a little rest after that second fret of the A. So I play that whole thing. I'll try and play it slow first. Make my finger so you can see all the notes. Open. Open. Just like that. Do it a little bit faster so you can kind of get the rhythm a little bit. Oops. And a lot of times, you know, when I'm playing that third, the first third fret of the E string, when you get used to this song, start giving a little vibrato. Just for fun, for color. All right, little Violent Femmes there for you. They have a lot of really fantastic bass lines. If you ever research that band and their bass lines, I'll definitely be putting some more up. It's really fun. They got the very unique acoustic bass sound, which is, you know, when they produce that, it sounds like an acoustic bass too. It's not, you know, it's not lost in the mix for sure there. Like, you know, sometimes you hear that someone had played an acoustic bass and you didn't even know it because of the way it was actually engineered. Their tunes, man, you know that is acoustic. But anyway, hope you enjoyed that. Again, stick with it, you know, keep practicing, and you'll absolutely get it. I'm Finbar of Finbar Bass. Don't forget to click on the clicker box right down there in the YouTube text box to get those free lessons, as I said. Other than that, you could always subscribe to Finbar Bass. That's my channel. Tons and tons of stuff on there, lots and lots of, there's definitely over 200 songs on there right now to learn. So especially if you're just starting out, you want, you know, a whole repertoire, you got it right there, bam, for free. There's also lots of you know, there's movie themes, there's TV show themes, there's video games on there, whatever it is that you're looking for. So enjoy that, and I will talk to you soon. Have fun with it.